Ladies and gentlemen, you're welcome to Gospel Drum. Wow, another exciting opportunity to bring the gospel to your home. My name is Doris Atanga. I'm going to be your host today. Today we have a surprise for you. We have a man of God all the way from Nigeria, a prophet of God, Prophet S.I. Owoeye, all the way from Nigeria. After the break, we'll get to meet him. Stay tuned. Welcome back to Gospel Drum. For those of you just tuning in, my name is Doris Atanga. I'm going to be your host today. And as I said earlier, we have a prophet of God all the way from Nigeria, Prophet S.I. Owoeye. Prophet, you're welcome to Gospel Drum.
Thank God Almighty. Akede onaiye o, akede onaiye. Fa won to ba gbagbo lati ba Jesu lo akede ona iye e wa gboro Jesu o mo tun gboro Jesu mi de are no rode o. God bless you.
You're welcome. What's the song? What's the meaning?
Yes, I have a program in Nigeria.
Okay.
I have sponsor many programs in Ekiti State, Osun State, Radio Nigeria, OYO, Amun Ludun, Amutajiro, and many stations in Nigeria.
Okay.
So anytime I want to start my program, that's the song I used to open the floor.
Oh, perfect, perfect. And with us in the studio today is Reverend Nathaniel Fagbenjo. You've been with us before. Yes. Good to have you again.
Amen. Thank God.
Amen. I understand Prophet is one of your mentors.
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so you have to be a good boy. Oh, you know?
Right. Yes. If he's not a good boy, I will not be around here
today. So I guess you're proud of him, right?
Yes.
Perfect. So the song, is that a worship song? Is that, what is the song?
The meaning of the song is are the way of internal life. People that proclaim the name, the way of internal life.
Okay.
So I'm here now, come and hear the name of Jesus Christ.
Wow.
So that's the meaning of the
Song.
Of the song.
Okay.
And that song has been his first, was his first album. And whenever he has studio like this,
yes,
he must first of all sing that song before he starts the program.
So he's your recording artist. He has been singing, he has albums.
Right.
Wonderful.
Right.
And Prophet, you've been to Rome, you've been to Jerusalem, you've traveled.
So,
all the places that you've been.
Well, I'm a bit at law.
You're still called a prophet.
I've been a prophet.
Yes, I've been in Jerusalem at least more than 7 times, at least 8 times.
Okay.
There's nowhere Jesus stepped in Jerusalem that I'm not stepping there.
Wow.
I've been in Rome, where they call Italy.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been in Spain, many, many countries.
Mm-hmm.
So before I come to this America.
Okay.
So what the Bible say in the Proverbs 8, verse 35, is that anybody see me, see life.
Okay.
So as you see me today, as people look at me in this television today, they have seen life. You will not suffer in your life.
Amen.
Go and write it down, to write this today's date.
Amen.
That's what I'm going through since almost 45 years.
Amen. Okay. And it's exciting that for 45 years you have been, you know, preaching the gospel. You've been everywhere. But many people like you will have so many titles in front of their name. You just maintain prophet of God.
Yes. I'm greatly happy about this question. This question is very important. It's strange that some people, I don't know, I cannot say, maybe they don't know what they are doing. If you are a prophet, there's no other name at all.
Okay.
When you are a prophet, you cannot go into somewhere to learn anything again, because anything you are doing is come from heaven.
Right.
You understand? So, a prophet is a prophet. Even what is going on in this country today, what is going on in the whole world today,
right?
God have shown the prophet. That is what is in Ezekiel 7,
right,
verse 25 and 26. Anything going on in the whole world,
mm-hmm,
in fact, in the Bible, Out of Apostle 3, verse 22 and 23. Other come from the Moses,
mm-hmm,
about the prophet. Anybody have a problem? If you want to settle the matter in anywhere in this world, if the matter is very difficult to settle, when the prophet is there, settle the matter.
Yes.
That's the end.
Amen.
That's the end.
Amen.
So prophet, I'm greatly happy about what I'm doing. I've worked many books.
Mm-hmm.
This what I'm telling you now is in the book.
Right.
Everything.
Right.
So I have many, what I call a bone.
Okay, the talent, the gift.
The talent.
And gift.
So many of my prophet I've seen, some people have a talent of three talent, four talent, mm-hmm, five talent, mm-hmm, six talent.
Okay.
But my own, I have about 121 talent.
Wow.
Okay.
Out of this 121 talent, I'm always wrote it down with the book.
Mm-hmm.
Dream book. Even this Bible, Psalm,
mm-hmm,
101 to 150.
Mm-hmm.
If somebody want to know the meaning, what is going there, I've written it down.
Wow.
It's in some of my book with you here.
Okay.
You can show people.
Okay.
That's the book. Say Jin Le Oro. Then by we at Igbo, at Abolate Benu in Davidi. This Abara Sam.
Sam.
Yes.
Power in the Sam.
Power in the Sam.
Okay. So here. And I understand that you in the area of dreams, God is really using you. How do you do that?
Yes. That's a miracle of God to prophet anywhere all over the world. There's no any dream somebody can have that can have. I mean, if you have any dream in this anywhere, I can interpret it.
Wow.
Yes, that's part of the talent God gave to me.
Oh, well, that's interesting. So you're like, so somebody tells you the dream that they had, and then you can interpret the dream.
Yes.
Oh, that's beautiful.
In fact, in 1983, I was in Italy.
Mm-hmm.
We had to call Rome.
Mm-hmm.
One of a white man there tell me that to stay in Rome because of the dream. Because say that there's not many people have a talent of a dream.
Okay.
So they want me to stay there. I said no.
Oh, okay. And this, I know you're just here, Reverend, to interpret for him.
Yes.
You're one of the people that he has mentored.
Right.
So what are some of the things you have learned from him? Because now God is using you in a mighty way. What are some of the things that you have really benefited?
Yeah,
crossing paths with this great man of God.
Yeah, this, as I've said and I've been said, he's a real man of God called by God as a prophet.
Mm-hmm.
And as you said, there's a difference between being a prophet and a pastor.
Okay.
As you just said, as a prophet of God, he focuses on his calling.
Okay.
And he's a very, 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 disciplined. When it comes to God, he does not care how you feel, what you say, to tell you the truth as he received from God.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one thing about him. Secondly, he was very disciplined. He's not doing this work because of monetary.
Mm-hmm.
So he's disciplined and maintain the calling.
Amen.
So that's one thing about him, and that's what I
learn
more. Good. Right, from him.
And Prophet, you said you're pastoring a church and you are focused on that particular ministry, even though you have some branches, and you're also pastoring. What's the difference, in your opinion, between a prophet and a pastor?
In fact, I believe that there's no establishment of a church without a pastor.
Mm-hmm.
Because the prophet cannot do the word.
Okay.
But the only work of a prophet is prophet.
Mm-hmm.
For example, this book, there's a book here.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay. This is a book called Agbara Adura.
Power of Prayer.
I want a leader
of the old prophet.
Jesus,
Jesus is coming.
Moshi iwe fun gbogbo agbalaye, everybody who call him mo iyato laarin woli ati prophet.
I wrote this book for everybody to know the difference between the prophet and the pastor.
Oh, okay.
For example, now, as I'm not going to school, I'm not going to college or anything, but a bit English I'm speaking now. You understanding me?
I'm enjoying it.
That's how I do it in Israel. Everywhere I go, I wrote this book. Who will not die?
Mm-hmm.
Who will not die? So, who will not die is an international book for the past 30 years.
Mm-hmm.
If anybody want to do something now, they will just put the name of their old mother, their old father, they put it back here. Who will not die? But my name will stay there by Prophet Owoeye.
Okay.
Now, this prophet line is very different in the whole world.
Mm-hmm.
This book called this Prayer of Destiny,
mm-hmm.
Adura Kadara. This book, if you don't want to go to anywhere to find out anything from where somebody, you put this small book, 150, small like this. You take the Bible, you open the Bible, you put that in it, that small book on the Bible. Then you read Psalm 20.
Okay.
Psalm 20. After you read Psalm 20, you call your name. You take one out of that book. The number you take, you open this book again, you will see the number here. Maybe it's warning you. Maybe it gives you a line. You have to go.
Okay.
Because before I come to this America now, I've watched it say that I want to go. You can go.
Okay. All right, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to talk about, you know, explain a little bit about the book. And as usual, if you want a copy of the books, if you want to know exactly, you know, the details, you can send us an email at staff@africangospelonline.com. But in the meantime, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to continue with finding out from the prophet what he's learned for the 45 years that he's been in ministry. Stay with us. Welcome back to Gospel Drum. We're having a good time here with Prophet S.I. Owoeye from Nigeria. He's actually from Way to Eternity Evangelical Ministry. Way to Eternity Evangelical Ministry. And he's just here, just sharing with us. For 45 years in ministry, he must have seen something, he must have learned something to share with us. And man of God, if God asks you, when you went to Rome, they wanted you to stay, and you did not want to stay. If God says, come to America for 1 year and do God's work, what are you going to bring new? What are you going to help us with?
Well, At least you see my age now. You see why it is. So what I'm willing to do is to see that everybody go through. The Bible, Matthew 6, verse 33, is giving us a very great way.
See first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
That is my will line.
Okay.
That's my will line. Just to shop after shop, there's something. What I'm winning? What I want to do again? God has given me. I build a house. I have a more vehicle. What I'm looking for? My son is. They are doing their own way. And I want everybody, the whole world. The whole America. World to go through life. If there's a truth, there's no problem. Because what is happening in this country now,
what is happening, which is wrong in this country, is the sin.
Okay.
Well, if there's no sin, there's no punishment. There is no death.
So if I'm here for a year in this America, I believe that nibiti oye ti agbara toni sin imo toto.
Where the knowledge is right now,
I will be
in America and people will be looking at me in Nigeria. In
Akede
on a way of light in Nigeria, in Ibadan.
So anywhere, the Bible say only hospital will lead the life.
Bible say there's nowhere we cannot be in the whole world. On the hill or on the floor, on the ground.
Amen.
I'm a singer.
He said, you know, you address the sin issue in America.
Right.
Do you have sin issue in Africa? I mean, I'm thinking.
And it's the same as Nigeria. So what not Nigeria? Sin has been equal everywhere.
Okay.
Sin is sin.
All right.
So,
women wears men's cloth.
Okay.
And men wears women's cloth.
Okay.
So, Bible says, no way, Deuteronomy 5 verse 22.
And the Bible says, the word of God saying the Bible said,
only come on,
that we should not do it.
So,
sin.
It's
rampant everywhere.
Okay, let's just say a little bit about clothing. So, which one is male clothing according to your principles, and which one is women clothing? If you may elaborate.
Shirley, orilede America nibi ti awaye at London.
In this country, in America, and as well in Europe.
The
problem there is different from Nigeria's problem.
Okay.
Because in America here, they are very cold. That even though you don't even know what to wear, because you just have to put whatever you can put on in order for cold, not to, you know, in order for you not to be cold.
But
in Nigeria or in Africa, it's very condition. Why do you have to put on trousers? Why do women have to wear trousers in Africa where it's very hot?
So if you have to copy
the writing or something that will can affect you.
That's all.
Okay. In the terms of the prophetic move in Africa, what I've seen, not just in Africa, even here in America, and I speak more from the African setting, people believe prophets more than they will believe a pastor.
In America, God loved them to believe prophet.
Okay.
That is why love them. That is why they believe prophet, the real prophet.
Because without a prophet, there's no Bible.
Right.
even though the Bible, without prophet, people go astray.
I want everybody look at me when you are talking to me about this prophet. Go to Bible.
Is it? Oh.
Matthew 10 verse 41. Wrote it down. Because what you talk, say about the medical law for a prophet, I'm greatly happy about them. God will guide them. Amen. They will be successful in their life. Amen. Because it's the director of the direction of God enlight you to law for a prophet. It's very good. Then second, this and Psalm 105 verse 15.
Mm-hmm.
During the time when Jesus is alive in Israel, prophet know about the dream.
Mm-hmm.
That's number one.
Mm-hmm.
Prophet know what can affect the king.
Mm-hmm.
But some of king by that time, they want to carry some many women's rubbish attitude.
Mm-hmm.
But the prophet annoyed that why you people they are looking as a father doing wrong things. So immediately God give order in Psalm 105 verse 15,
mm-hmm.
warning the king,
mm-hmm.
they should not do anything against the prophet. So if anybody loved the prophet, he's showing that God loved him too. He himself is the prophet. That's another Amos 3, verses 2-7. That's number one. That's out of it. Ezekiel 7, verse 25 to 26. So, she apostolic.
Mm-hmm.
3, verse 22 to 23. That's the order from Moses.
Okay. I'm glad you gave us all these scriptures about, you know, the role of the prophet is very important in the church. But with the way people are having itchy ears in these last days, people don't want to know the word of God. As a prophet, you give a scripture, say read. They don't want to read. They want to hear you say, tomorrow
you will ride the car. Tomorrow you ride the plane.
Uh-huh. Right. Are you having, has it become worse in your 45 years of ministry, or is still the same from the time you started?
No. That's it. In fact, this what you are saying is very, very important. It's very, very important. Where are you going? If you have the vehicle, you have the plane, you have everything. Without heaven, it's nothing. Even the richest, I was in Jerusalem. I go to where they call Solomon Temple. That's where Solomon built a very big house. So he think that after build the house and have a wife and have everything, that's what he think that. Is the highest thing he's going to do to succeed.
Okay.
But after that, everything was just paralyzed.
Okay.
And the Solomon called people in his right in Owoeye. Oniwasu. Okay. No, Wasu. He called everybody. Wasu Mwongo Eswe. Owoeye, only 700 wife.
Mm-hmm.
Only Ali, that is 300.
300 concubine.
So
700
wife and 300
concubine.
Together it's 1,000.
Mm-hmm.
After that, they say that it's
nothing.
What is telling people that you see only Jesus? You see somebody, only one man.
Amen.
So that's the thing. Why are you preaching of money? Oh. Money. Orisha lewo, Orisha.
Amen.
Orisha lewo.
Money is an adult.
The great money, I believe, is very important in the world. Is this in studio now?
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Yes. Somebody established type of this studio where they are washing people to learn it.
Mm-hmm.
That's the only thing.
Amen.
What is the next?
Amen. Okay, Prophet, because of time, I want you to look in that camera and speak to the people who are watching. Tell them what they need to know in this camera right here. Just tell them, you know, give them a message if you want to pray for them, anything you want to tell them. You know, just talk to the people.
Yes. Yes. I prophesize to you today. If you leave anything like sin, you face the way of God, you are watching, you are reading the Bible. Because my sister said that some people don't want to know the Bible. If you don't know the Bible, it's a sinner. You are watching the Bible every time. You know the type of, even if somebody have want to harm you, God can relate to you. But in what is happening in the world today now, nobody, the Bible is out of our apostle. That is 2, verse 17. You have to watch it. You're supposed to remember dream. You're supposed to have a dream. Anything like that. God is in the Bible. So I pray for you. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God guide you.
Amen.
You will not die.
Amen.
You will not lost.
Amen.
You are the son of God.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever, if you are going with Bible, there's no problem. Everything you need is there. You want to have your money, it's there. But why are you turning your life into rubbish people? If you face the way of God, God will guide you. Amen. I pray for you. God will guide you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. And I give you this psalm in the Bible. That's Psalm 31. This is Psalm 51. That one we give you, we carry all the rubbish thing you have been doing before. You just carry it out of it. It will not affect you. And then Psalm 27, we give you a power of half a good Iboya.
Okay. Uh-huh. Boldness.
Boldness. That's Psalm 27. Mm-hmm. Another Psalm is Psalm 31. That's Psalm 31 and 26 there. It gives you that there's no any Christian that God will not guide. Amen. In the world. God. Amen. Bless you.
Amen. Amen. Okay, thank you, Prophet, for that word of encouragement. We're going to take a break. When we come back, Prophet mentioned something earlier to us about the prayer of destiny. And he mentioned to us about using the book and, you know, being able to find out what your destiny is. So we're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to talk about prayer of destiny. Stay tuned.
Hi, I'm Nabila Pefok from Dunamis Life Chapel, and you're watching Gospel Drum. Be transformed, inspired, and encouraged.